we just saw an exhibition of 80 female artists that's been inspired by Virginia Woolf. What made her a game changer in the literary world?
Well, I think there are several things. One is that she was someone who changed the form of the novel. She really came out of the movement that brought post-impressionism to the world. She was part of a generation that deliberately wanted to throw away a lot of the norms of fiction. But then, of course, she was also someone who was very conscious of the difference that being a woman made. And I think that's had a great deal of influence on subsequent generations.
Well, that brings me to my next question. How important are her works like Three Guineas and A Room of One's Own for gender equality?
Well, I think it's interesting that you ask about both of them, because A Room of One's Own, I think, is probably a lot better known generally. But Three Guineas might be more relevant now, because her argument there is really that war and violence is something that is produced by a system rather than by individuals. And she wrote A Room of One's Own really as a consequence of an argument she had with a friend about why there had been, you know, no great women, very few great women writers. And her argument was that it took a culture to produce the kind of artists that were successful, and that traditionally women's position in that culture had been not one that promoted their abilities, but it actually repressed their abilities. So that, in terms of your question about gender equality, I think in A Room of One's Own, she writes that she hopes one day it will be immaterial whether one's a man or a woman. So she's writing about a kind of more traditional approach to equality, whereas in Three Guineas, I think that she's really looking at patriarchy and a system that's produced by education and that reproduces itself.
Let's talk about her state of mind for a bit. Some people say her creativity was caused by mental illness, and we know she took her own life by drowning. What are your thoughts on that?
Well, I think there's a kind of cliche about artists being mad, which is a rather romantic idea that, you know, artists are very different kinds of people who are a little crazy. But I think that's, as I said, a kind of an old-fashioned idea about creativity. Woolf certainly struggled with mental instability throughout her life, and there's been a vast literature exploring that, speculating about its causes and so on. But I think one of the things that's most remarkable about her is that she had an uncanny ability to kind of step back and look at herself and see her own consciousness as something that was really something that informed her creativity, that she was able to look at herself as a creator and also look at her state of mind as something that helped her to understand, you know, characterization and the creation of her fictions. But I don't think it's true to, you know, make a one-to-one correspondence between mental instability and creativity.
Mm-hmm. Well, Mark, thank you so much for giving us that great insight, joining us there from New York.
Thank you.